Okay, so Funk 49, James Gang. Fantastic song, just a song that every rock guitar player needs to know how to play. And I think most guys know it's Joe Walsh. And just a great lick, you know, just super classic. So we'll go over that. But one thing I wanted to mention before I start is just how great the band is. And the drummer and the bass player, the drummer is Jim Fox, and the bass player was Dale Peters. And I didn't know that. I had to look that up when I was researching the song. But really, just absolutely phenomenally good rhythm section there. So, you know, credit, of course, all credit goes to Joe Walsh, but a lot of credit should go to those two guys too, because man, those guys can play. Anyways, okay, so we're in A, and you know, I'm pretty sure he played this on a Strat, so you know, I'm doing a Les Paul, obviously. So I've got this switch here that splits my pickups, so I've got it into single coil mode here. I got very little gain on my amp, and I've got my volume down to about 7 or so, just to clean it up a bit. Okay, so we're going to start with that lick. It's just in this first position A minor pentatonic, and it's just going to bend up here on G7, right? And then kind of let that go, and little finger here on B8. And then we come back down and bend it down. And we pull off to that. Okay, don't pluck that. Don't go. It's. And you put a little hook on that one, right? And then we're just going to go. Start with a pre-bend. And we hit it 4 times, gradually bringing it down each time. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're going to go. Right, just pull offs from G7, G5, open. D7, D5, open. Okay, and then the lick's going to start. So that whole thing. Okay, and that first chord is an A7. Okay, so think of it, that bar chord, and then think of it like this. And then just think of it without, you know, your third finger. So we're getting that G note there, which is the 7th, right? So root, 7, 3rd, 5th. But we're really focusing more on that 7th and 3rd, okay? So. And the first time, he's hammering that third on, right? And you're playing that open A, and you drift it down. And then we're gonna bar here, like doing a D bar chord. And we just play the D, G, and B strings there on 7th fret. And we go back to that, so. And the whole thing, it's funk, right? Obviously, funk 49. So we gotta, you know, we're kind of playing drums on the guitar in this song, right? Like, I don't know if you saw that James Brown movie recently. Get it up. I can't remember. But it was a really cool scene in that movie where he went around to each band member because they were, I don't know, something was happening. They weren't getting along. They didn't like the way things were going, the arrangements. And he asked every guy in the band, he said, "What instrument are you playing?" You know, he asked the bass player. And the bass player goes, "I'm playing the drums," you know, and he asked every guy in the band, and they all answered the same thing, because that's what he wanted to hear, right? So it's all about playing drums on guitar, right? So you got to keep that rhythm going, okay? So. And the only real time you hit that open A is on that first lick, right? Drift it down, drift that one down, and then we're up here, which is like, you know, again a D chord, right? We're gonna put our, you know, that shape there, which is, it's like an F chord, a G chord, right? Okay, so I don't know if you can see, but that's B8, and D9, and chords barring here. We kind of hammer that on. Right? And you maybe want to give it a bit of that too, a little vibrato. And that drifts down too the first time, right? And then here. They all drift down that first time. And then we hit that open A, okay? So real slow would be. Open A, right? And then we get in, the drums coming and everything, and then we're more rhythmic. So now we're gonna go. You know, we're just short. And that's the key there, is hammering on that third against the seventh. So. And that is. Right, da da da, da, back. A backstroke on that one. And don't hit that high either. Definitely don't hit that. We're back picking that. We want to start on the B string. And open A. So real slow, once the drums come in, that's going to be like. Okay, and that's the lick. Yeah, classic. It's real feel lick, obviously, right? So you got to just really kind of, you know, you don't want to really think about this too much. You just want to get in the feel of it. Okay, and then we get into the second part of it, which is this. That part there. And we're just. Right, just that part of the pentatonic first position, and then we go into that extension. That extension box. There. Right, so. And that slides up, okay? Because there's a number of reasons you want to slide that up with your first finger. Rather, like I used to go, right, with my third finger because it just felt better. But the thing is, now you gotta get to this A7 chord, which is the next thing, right? Just like an A chord, but take your little finger off. So you're getting that G there, the seventh. So if you use your third finger, you just have to move it, you know? You have to shift again, right? So it's really important. Well, I think it is anyways. I mean, if you're a really good guitar player, probably didn't even make any difference, but it makes it easier if we slide it up with our first finger, because then we're right there for that chord, right? And later on, when we're going to get to that E7 sharp 9, it's real easy to get to there from here, not so much from there to there, right? It's still, it's not hard, but this is easier. So, anyways. Okay, that's the first lick. And then we go. Chicka, eat it, chicka, boom, right? It's funk, right? So we got that little chicka thing in between. Okay. And that's that A7. And he seems to play mostly the first three strings. But if you play all of them, it won't matter. And I think I wound up hitting most of them in the demo. And the second time, we don't hit the chord. We just slide up, put a little vibrato, and slide it back down. Okay, so both those parts. And we do it again. And then we just take it up two frets to B, right? Right? And then we end it with this. That E7 sharp 9. Okay. And this is like the Jimi Hendrix chord, right? And like I said before, don't go. Because it's a little harder to make that change. But, you know, it really doesn't matter, actually. If you can make that change clean, it doesn't matter. But I just find it easier Real easy. Make sure I'm getting a good clean change on that, because that's a huge chord, big chord, right? Okay, then we're back into it. Okay, and that's it. That's all there is to that one. It's a little more simple than a lot of the stuff I've been doing lately. But then again, you know, if you watch some of my videos, I don't really care about it, simple or complicated. It's, you know, it's how good it is. And this is just an awesome lick. And, you know, you can see, if you watch Phil X on YouTube here, he's always playing this song. Because, you know, he just loves it. And I can see why, man. This is such a great lick to play. And it's so much fun to jam on. So, anyways, I hope you get something out of this. Hope you enjoy playing it. And we'll see you next time.